Winningest Washington Redskins coach of all time, today back in Washington, but as head coach of the Chicago Blitz. Key player, rookie running back Tim Spencer, number 46, out of Ohio State. As a senior last year, he led the Big Ten in rushing, a bruising short yardage runner with the speed to get outside. Tim Spencer would almost certainly have been a first-round pick in any league's draft. The opponents, the Washington Federals, coached by Ray Yock, quite a different man from George Allen, but a very successful coach in his own right in the Canadian Football League. And their key player, another star rookie running back, wearing number 32 just as he did at Southern Methodist University, Craig James. Like Spencer, big and strong, very fast. Like Spencer, he too would be a first-round pick in any draft. ABC Sports presents... season premiere of the United States Football League. Today, live from RFK Stadium in Washington, D.C., it's the Chicago Blitz versus the Washington Federals. The scene live in RFK Stadium. George Allen on the sidelines for the first time here since 1977. Across the way, Ray Yock, coaching here after 12 years in the Canadian Football League as head coach of the Washington Federals. A drizzly cold day, not unlike the kind of weather you would expect here in RFK Stadium in late October or early November. It feels like football weather. Hello, I'm Jim Lampley, and I'll be honest with you. I will wait to see how many of you are that anxious to see football in spring, but everything I've seen and heard in the past 3 weeks leads me to believe that this experiment, the United States Football League, has a great chance of flying. Clearly, in my view, there are enough pro football players to go around for this league to field a credible product. And clearly, there are enough big-name football coaches, some of them with long-standing identities in American football, who are willing to commit themselves to this project. The rest is up to you, but if you're going to stick with us today, you're going to see a lot of new faces and a fascinating storyline. One of the new faces, Lee Corso, who is working here with us at ABC for the first time, formerly the head coach at the University of Indiana and one of about two dozen college football coaches whose contributions to American higher learning have been terminated in this past fall football season. Lee, very nice to have you with us. We're going to see in the personalities of George Allen and Ray Yock, two entirely different men, one of them well-known to Americans, one of them not known at all.
Yeah, absolutely. Everybody knows George Allen. They've heard about him. He's a fine football coach. But when you get down to it, I've known Ray Yock for about 10 years, and I'm very impressed with him. He's an intense individual. He looks a lot older than he is, you know, but that's because he was a head coach a long time. He come out of the Canadian League with Edmonton and Winnipeg, and he knows how to win.
One of the big stories in this league and in its prospective success, the development of rookie players, and we've got three very important ones here today. Trumaine Johnson and Tim Spencer on the Blitz.
Yeah, on a Blitz team of 46, Spencer, in my opinion, when he played for Ohio State, particularly the last three ball games, and I say this because I saw him in the flesh, I don't think there's a better football player in America, including Herschel Walker. I'll be interested to see how he compares to Walker at the end of the year. And Trumaine Johnson, everybody talks about him because when Coach Eddie Robinson from Grambling says he's one of the best football players he's ever coached, he's got to be dynamite.
On the other side, number 32, Craig James of the Washington Federals, another very big name.
And a very fine football player. He's a strong, hard runner. His problem is how much blocking he's going to get, you know, because the offensive line for the Federals is a little young, and you're only as good as an offensive lineman when you're a running back.
That's Lee Corso, who'll be with us all day, one of the most entertaining men in football, and we look forward to having a couple of laughs and enjoying what could be a very good football game here. George Allen, in his return to Washington with the Chicago Blitz, we'll be back right after this. We're back in RFK Stadium for the climax of what has been a very festive weekend here in Washington. The Federals hosted an inaugural ball for the United States Football League Friday night. There was a good deal of activity around here at the stadium yesterday when the Blitz arrived to practice, and a lot of people came out to see George Allen. And right now, Lou Rawls, one of the greatest singers on this continent, is going to render an a cappella version of our national anthem.
The United States Air Force, honor guard, under the direction of Senior Airman Joe Johnson, while they're staying at attention, we invite you to stand, please, for the singing of our national anthem by special guest.
see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight for the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave over the land of the free and the home of the brave?
And as Lou Rawls fills the place up with his voice, the balloons are released and the festivities continue. You will be surprised to learn, perhaps, that the red, white, and blue uniforms do not belong to the Washington Federals. The Chicago Blitz wear red, silver, and blue with some white trim. And the colors of the Washington Federals are green and black, which are also the colors of the Federals' owner, Burl Bernard's yacht. He's a yacht racer. The Federals have won the coin toss and will receive. And the Blitz will be kicking off. There are the weather conditions, 54 degrees, wind about 8 miles an hour out of the northeast, 90% humidity, and that says it all. The rain has been falling most of the morning and all through the early afternoon here at RFK Stadium. The field was under a tarp until about an hour and a half ago, but it is bound to be wet, if not sloppy. Certainly wet right now. Deep to receive. Number 44 on the right of your screen is Mike Guest out of Ohio State, a defensive back. And number 16 on the left was Reggie Smith. Remember him, the tiny one from Atlanta, 5'4" tall. And there's Frank Corral, who you remember from the Rams and UCLA, an Allen favorite, kicking off as Reggie Smith picks it up at the 8-yard line and has a big opening across the 35 to the 38-yard line. A little boost for the Federals as they get ready to go on offense. Number 57, Doak Field, reserve linebacker out of Baylor, made the stop for the Blitz. And Reggie Smith will stay in the ball game at one wide receiver. Yep. The other starting wide receiver will be Mark Brown. There are the skill position starters. The quarterback, Kim McQuilkin, you'll remember as a backup for the Falcons and the Redskins. And along the offensive front, there are not any household names there. Perhaps the strongest blocker, number 60, a rookie right tackle out of Maryland, Dave Pacella. In the backfield with McQuilkin, number 32 will be James. Number 39, James Mayberry, the fullback out of Colorado, formerly with the Falcons. The other wide receiver is Mark Brown, a rookie from Towson State. And on first down, it will be James. He is going to be dumped. First man back there was number 52, Stan White, and number 28, Don Schwartz. Strong safety came up to finish James off. Call it a loss of 3 back to the 35, and it will be second and 13.
Come on, Steve!
McQuilkin is number 11. And number 32, now in the split back formation, is Craig James. James. Excellent tackle on the corner by number one, Frank Minifield, rookie cornerback out of Louisville. Yes, he's the cousin of Dirk Minifield of Kentucky, and James picked up 3 yards to get back to the original line of scrimmage. So Lee Corso, third and 10, and already it appears that the inexperienced offensive line is having difficulty for the Federals.
Absolutely. Their first play they tried was a little misdirection play, and I think if the rain doesn't stop, they're going to have to go right at the blitz a little bit more, which means directly right at them and not around the ends.
There are a lot of George Allen-style veterans on this blitz defense. We'll be naming them for you as they come into the ballgame. Eddie Brown, remember him, the kick returner for the Redskins and the Rams, is now in as the nickelback on third and 10. Pass batted down, and that was number 70, Kit Lathrop, rookie defensive tackle out of Arizona State, who snuffed Kim McQuilkin's passing attempt, and the Federals will get ready to kick the ball away. Punter is back in formation. Number 89, deep to receive, is Lenny Willis, the wide receiver out of Ohio State. Number 3, Steve Hoffman from Dickinson College, will do the punting for the Federals. Craig James was a great punter in college. He's not kicking for the Federals because they expect him to have a heavy workload in all other areas. Hoffman barely gets it away. Willis calls for the fair catch and makes it at the 30-yard line of the blitz. So, a 32-yard kick for Steve Hoffman, and you can see that it was almost blocked.
They come from the outside. They had a 10-man blitz here, and it takes a chance. The great thing about that is that kid stayed right in there, Hoffman, and kicked the ball without the pressure.
So here come the blitz. The quarterback is Greg Landry, 36 years old. You'll remember him with the Lions and the Colts and long ago at the University of Massachusetts. And on first down, the give is to Spencer and Donnie Harris. Strong safety, the free safety, I should say, brings him down, but not before Spencer gets all the way to the 39-yard line. A pickup of 7. Maybe a short 8, and it'll be second down 2 or 3. Landry, Spencer, Kevin Long, formerly of the Jets, Wayman Bugs, Trumaine Johnson in the skill positions for the Chicago Blitz. Second down, call it a long 2. With the football, Benny Smith, number 92, first-year defensive tackle out of Missouri, made the stop for the Federals, but Spencer was able to pick up enough for the first down, so the first down of the ball game. Offensive line, Ricker, Taylor, Stevenson, Wally Pursuit, Tim Norman, and Nick Ayer. So the blitz, already demonstrated they will be moving the football on the ground. It was a great hold for Spencer on first down. This is Spencer again. And this time, he is snuffed in the defensive backfield as Benny Smith was able to get back there.
Jim, you can see automatically that the blitz plan is to go right at this young defensive team of the Federals. Right at him means run straight at him, not too fancy.
There's a look at Benny Smith. He made the play for the Federals. It was a loss of 2. It is second down, 12 yards to go. No flag. Trumaine Johnson has his first reception in the United States Football League. Short of a first down, out of bounds at the 48-yard line, still in blitz territory.
All right, now you watch Trumaine. He uses his speed. In other words, he's got that guy afraid he's going to go deep. He just turns out, catches it. Great delivery, great timing. Landry to Trumaine Johnson.
Pickup of 9 yards on the play. Perhaps the biggest concern for the Federals' defensive staff coming into the ballgame was how to cope with Trumaine Johnson. Like most of their team, the Federal secondary is somewhat inexperienced. Third down now. The ball must get to the 48 of Washington for a first down. Good throw down the middle, number 88. Another Wookiee ride receiver, Wayman Bugs, out of Vanderbilt, has the first down for the blitz at the 37-yard line of Washington on a 14-yard pickup.
At that time, you could see Landry, he goes back. They put a man in motion, Bugs, and this makes the people in the backfield move around. Now watch him. He drives himself deep.
He does a little squaring across the middle. They had good protection, and Landry drops the ball right into the hole. Watch this nice concentration, looking the ball right in his hand. Boom. Good shot.
So now with first down at the 37-yard line. Spencer gets the ball up the middle. Coy Bacon, one of the real venerable attractions in this league. And it was Kevin Long, not Spencer. Correct myself, 48, not 46. In his fifth year as a pro out of South Carolina.
Jim, most of the ball games are 1 and 5 minute segments. First 5 minutes of the ball game, very important on who establishes the line of scrimmage. Right now, the blitz has the best of it because they're controlling the inside area.
Second down, 5 after the pickup by Long of 5 yards. This time there will be flags. Looks as though the right guard, Tim Norman, of the blitz may have jumped. We'll await the call. There are some rules differences here. We'll bring you up to date on them later. The call is against the blitz, so that will move it back out to the 37 or 38-yard line and make it second down 10.
That'll happen sometimes, particularly in the early part of the season, because they're trying to change around their snap count.
There are some of the rules differences, Lee. Optional two-point conversion, just like college football.
I know pass about that one.
Yes, sir. It's ruined a lot of coaches' careers.
Including mine.
The pass interference difference is perhaps the most significant one. They have a kicking tee here, not in the NFL. And during the last 2 minutes of each half, a first down stops the clock. Nickel defense now, 5 defensive backs in the game for Washington. So the blitz come with the draw play. Good call, and Spencer has a healthy pickup, perhaps another first down. In fact, it is another first down at the 26.
Now watch Spencer. He sets up in what they call a trap. Now watch the tackle come down and trap that guy. Boom, there goes Spencer, 46. Makes a cut behind Airy, number 78, drives, and he's a fine football player. 14 yards, first down.
It'll be second down 14 at the 29.
Those things will happen at the beginning of the season. I don't care what league, if it's at the elementary school. But this situation here will be worked out as they play longer and longer.
Greg Landry, 36 years old, and of course not regarded as a mobile quarterback. That has never been a high premium for George Allen offense. Looking for Johnson. Good play. Donnie Harris. No, check it. Jeff Brown, 36, not 26. Jeff Brown, the rookie cornerback out of Liberty Baptist, was the man who was back there with Johnson.
He had him beat. Now, remember, this is the same situation where he scared that guy going out. And the kid Brown, the rookie, goes up right up here, makes a great deflection with his right hand. Tremendous football play by Brown. You notice they go right after the rookie in clutch situations. That's George Allen's theory.
So now it is third down, 14. You get a look at Jeff Brown. And once again, he matches up head-on-head against Trumaine Johnson. Benny Smith, all of them surrounded Landry.
Watch Coy Bacon now. He makes a good outside move on number 75. Taylor. Rob Taylor's only a rookie, see? A rookie from Northwestern, and that guy Bacon's been playing longer than Taylor's been living. And he moved him with a great outside move.
So the Blitz, who were pushed out of field goal range by that sack, will punt the ball away. And the deep men for the Federals are standing at the 10-yard line. 22 is Buddy Hardeman, a former Redskin. 16 is Reggie Smith. Mike Guess is up short. And the flag will be for delay of game against the Blitz.
Now, they did that on purpose, and the reason they did that was to move the ball 5 yards further away from the end zone line, so they'll have 5 more yards to drop it inside. That was a deliberate play right there by the coaching staff.
Again, Frank Corral will drop back. Corral will do all of the kicking for the Blitz. Kickoffs, place kicks, and punting. Only been in camp for about a week, but he told me he believes his leg is in mid-season shape or something close to it. Angling for the corner, and it's going to go into the end zone. So he missed. The ball will come out to the 20-yard line, just as in any football league. And Washington will go on offense for the second time in the ball game. In the first quarter here at RFK Stadium, 8 minutes and 12 seconds left in the quarter, we've got no score. So here are the Federals for the second time with Kim McQuilkin at the control. Craig James wrapped up. 71 is Carl Lorch, an old George Allen favorite. 70 is Kit Latham.
Now you see they're going right to James immediately again, right at him, like I said before, because of the weather conditions, you've got to run right at people and try to slow that pass rush down.
Look at the USFL ball, which is 3/8 of an inch shorter than an NFL ball. You'd be surprised how much difference that can make in the feel of the ball. Gets outside for a little bit, across the 25 and to the 27-yard line.
That was the same type of play that the Blitz used against him. It was a draw play. Watch the quarterback come back. He'll show like it's going to be a pass. He gives it to James. Right here, watch this move to the right. That's good. Breaks it, voids it. Watch him lean forward for that extra yard. Right there, you can't coach that.
Good block on the play by James Mayberry, number 39, the fourth-year fullback out of Colorado. You'll remember him for the Falcons, who used to block for William Andrews and Lynn Kane. Third down, 3 yards to go. Wilkin gets away from one man. Flag is down as James drops the ball. James had beaten Stan White. Would have had a pickup of about 20 yards. And very quickly, let's go down to Al Lerner of our Chicago station WLS, who's on the sidelines with Coy Bacon.
Coy, is the hitting, anything comparable to the NFL in this first series?
Well, it's good football. That's all I can say for right now. It's going to be a good league. And a lot of young talent out there. And it's going to be a good game.
Okay, thank you very much. Let's go back up to Jim and Lee.
All right, thanks, Al. And that was 39-year-old Coy Bacon, 15 years out of Jackson State, the Rams, the Chargers, the Bengals, the Redskins, and he can still play.
The holding penalty was declined there. They wanted the football.
So it is 4th down 3. That is Lenny Willis, deep to receive again for the Blitz, as Steve Hoffman prepares to kick it away for the Federals. Hoffman's last kick was 32 yards, and you'll recall that it was very nearly blocked.
Looks like they're coming again, Jim.
And once again, they were close. Again, Willis will call the fair catch, leans forward, and manages to gather it in at the 44-yard line. And this was a 29-yard kick for Hoffman, who is not exactly having a big day with the punts. We'll be back. You want cheerleaders? We've got 60 of them here today. 30 have been outfitted for each team. George Allen does not notice cheerleaders when he's on a football field. Bob Barber, number 90, is now in the ball game for Bacon at defensive end. That's a frequent substitution we'll see in running situations. But Landry wants to throw, now comes out of the huddle, and gets his 36-year-old legs across the 45 and up to the 48-yard line before Ed Baxley, the middle linebacker, dropped him. It's gain of 4, it'll be 2nd and 6.
Looks like the Blitz's theory is they're going to run Spencer on first down, or they're going to fake Spencer. Now watch. Yeah, watch it. He makes a nice fake here to Spencer. Remember that play they've been running? He sets his feet deep. The protection breaks down. But watch him make a little quick move here. I like this part, though. He tucks the ball away at the last minute. Notice 2 hands? He ought to. He's old enough. He ought to know that.
2nd down 5. Federal showing Blitz. They give it to Spencer going in the other way, and he gets only a couple. Good play out at the corner by Barber, number 90, who jammed things up as did Farley Bell, number 57, an outside linebacker from Cincinnati. Spencer now in the ball game, 5 carries for 23 yards.
You'll notice the difference in the grass in your picture. The middle of the field is solid grass, and the other side, both sides are painted green.
Now here's an either-way call on 3rd and 3. Ball right at midfield. Trumaine Johnson again, down to the 36-yard line. Nothing that Jeff Brown could do about it, as Trumaine got the inside on the curl pattern and the ball was well thrown.
Okay, now watch Johnson. He's got such great speed, he scares that guy to death. That's Butler back, and he comes back, scares Brown to death, gets the first down. A perfectly thrown ball and a very imaginative call on that situation.
Pick up of 14 yards. Another first down for the Blitz. This time Johnson is to the near side.
Watch out. What did I tell you?
He's going to go.
Watch. Oh!
Loses the football. Loose in the end zone. Oh. Touchdown.
Touchdown. All right.
Number 88, Wayman Bugs, gets credit for the touchdown. On the recovered fumble after a 34-yard pass completion to Trumaine Johnson. Hesitate to say that you could see it coming.
Well, I tell you what, that's a great play because they faked the sweep one way and they came back and threw a screen. When you've got a great player like Trumaine Johnson, Jim, you want to get the ball in his hands as many times as you can in different situations. That time he just made a great individual athletic ability play, scored a touchdown. Should have scored a touchdown.
Corral's holder is the backup quarterback number 14, Tim Cagle. You may remember him at Notre Dame, formerly at Moeller High School under Jerry Faust. Robert Barnes, the backup guard, snaps the ball. Corral nails the extra point. And with 4 minutes, 25 seconds left in the first quarter, the Blitz leads 7-0.
Okay, now watch Johnson. He'll fake 2 steps up the field, steps back, and gets a screen. Now the theory is watch those big gorillas out in front of him. 73, 65. He makes a break here, gets up the field. Now the one thing he doesn't do, he doesn't put the ball away. The guy strips the ball, and now it's all over. Everybody's jumping when those linemen thinks they got a chance.
And the man who finally wound up with the ball was Wayman Bugs. So it's 7-0 Chicago, and we'll be back. Well, to the degree that anybody can be called an expert on a league which hasn't played any games, most of the people who regard themselves as experts have picked the Blitz to win the championship in this league, and they have lived up to expectations early, as deep to receive are number 16, Reggie Smith, and number 44, Mike Guess. Short kick. And here goes Reggie Smith. At the 27-yard line where the Federals will have the ball. What's happening in L.A.? Let's go to Frank Gifford in New York.
Thank you, Jim. Herschel Walker's 4th carry of the day for the New Jersey Generals against the L.A. Express. 5-yard touchdown run. Herschel Walker looking awfully good, awfully big, awfully fast. He's carried the ball 4 times for 24 yards. Back to you, Lance.
So Herschel Walker has already begun to make his mark. Kim McQuilkin brings the Federals out on their 3rd possession of the ball game. Still without a first down. Number 16 is Reggie Smith. All the way to the 49-yard line. Pick up of 22 yards. Virgil Livers, number 24, dragged him down.
Executed blast. It was in a spot pass. The quarterback dropped back 3 steps and threw to an area. Watch. He'll go 1, 2, 3. He'll throw to a spot right there. And it's the receiver's responsibility, Smith, to get there. Breaks a tackle. A very, very fine football play. First down. And I think that's the first one they've got.
Finding the spot in the zone between Livers, the cornerback, and Don Schwartz, the safety. On first down, Craig James hits hard across the 50 and down to about the 48-yard line of the Blitz. Jim Fonhorst, rookie linebacker out of Minnesota, number 55, made the stop. There are the stats on the scoring drive for the Chicago Blitz. 56 yards, four plays, and of course, Wayman Bugs getting the touchdown on the fumble recovery in the end zone after a 33-yard reception there, calling it officially, by Trumaine Johnson, who fumbled the ball. McQuilkin on second down. Off. Frank Minifield had a shot at a wobbly pass. Now let's go down to Al Lerner, who's with Wayman Bucks.
Wayman, the first USFL touchdown, it wasn't pretty, but you'll take it.
I think it's great. Trumaine made a great run on it. I just happened to be in the right place at the right time.
They hitting hard out there?
Not really. You know, everything has been going pretty good for us, and we're just looking forward to going back out and drive the ball down the field on them again.
Nice touchdown. Back to you upstairs.
Third down and 10 yards to go now. Number 22, Buddy Hardeman, a former Washington veteran, is in the ball game. And now the officials are going to take a moment to discuss something. I'm a little confused by the spotting of the ball because I believe that it was supposed to be in blitz territory at the 48. And they have moved it back to the original line of scrimmage at the Washington 49. James picked up 3 yards on the first down play.
Well, it's their first game, too, right?
In case you're wondering who they are, the referee is Tommy Miller. The head linesman is Jim Mahan. The umpire is Tony Kramer. The line judge, Tony Viteri. The back judge, Bill Wright. And the field judge, Wes Ward.
All household names.
Some of those NFL officials have become household names over the years, to be sure. Gentlemen are hoping just as much as everyone else in the league that they have a future. And for once in my life, I was right. They do move the football down to the 47-yard line. How do you like that?
Tell them the truth. You looked at the scoreboard.
I'm entitled. Buddy Hardeman, former Redskin utility back, is in there. So is Joey Walters, an outstanding wide receiver up in the Canadian Football League who just came down a few days ago. McQuilkin loses the football. 74 who made the hit is Joe Ehrman. And I did not catch for sure the man who fell on the ball, but 56, Ed Smith, a linebacker out of Vanderbilt, they nickname him the Sheriff, is going to get credit for the recovery.
Okay, you watch a quarterback drop back. He has no problem here. McQuilkin, he sets his feet good, but Ed Ehrman just too much for that Horton and beats him to the outside and comes from the inside and wraps him up right there and he fumbles the ball. I would not be surprised to see Holen, see number 9, start warming up for the Feds. They have not moved the ball effectively.
Rookie quarterback Mike Hohensey out of Minnesota. Federals coaches are very high on him and they made no bones about the fact that they won't stay with McQuilkin all day if he's not putting points on the board. Kevin Long with the ball. Hard hit out on the corner, but not before Long picked up about 5 yards. Bob Barber, number 90, was there, and Ron Este, number 55, was also in on.
Yeah, watch this Baxley, the middle linebacker. He comes from the inside. Kevin Long's got good foot. He doesn't see Baxley right here. Wow! Does he knock him? Has a heck of a play from South Carolina, Baxley.
Hitting Kevin Long, who also played at South Carolina. Second down, 4. They called it a gain of 6. Bugs is in motion on the far side, and this is Spencer, the tailback. Pickup of 3, he'll be about a yard short of a first down.
You notice a lot of the times they'll run Spencer from the I formation. There's a good picture of the young man. That's because that's what he ran at Ohio State, and they like to do things that the players are familiar with.
He gained 3,400 yards, close to it in his career. How many of those were against your teams at Indiana?
The last time we played him, he 33 rushes for 192 yards. Not bad.
Good job, Coach. The Blitz have picked up 2 of their 3 third downs so far in the ballgame. This is the 4th one. And that's going to be close. It was Spencer with the football. It was Ed Baxley who met him head up at the line of scrimmage.
It looked like the way the official number 36 spotted it, it's going to be a first down with a measurement, but I think it's going to be a first down without one.
No need to measure because the yard marker was right on the line and he has pushed the ball across the line, so it's another blitz first down at the 35-yard line of the Federals. Now, Trumaine Johnson, who had gone out for a moment, comes back into the ballgame. And the Blitz are now 3 of 4 on third down.
You might wonder why they take Trumaine Johnson out in a situation like that. They need blockers, not great receivers, on a short yardage situation.
Looks like the Blitz center, Wally Pursuit, doesn't like the way the ball was spotted there.
Or it could be wet. The center has the right to ask for a dry ball at any time he wants.
Now Landry reopens the lines of communication. Looking sharp so far, and this may be a delay of game call against the Blitz. Indeed. That will irritate George Allen, who likely will think that the officials were more responsible for that delay than his ball players were.
And he's going to tell that official right there. But I tell you what, this is going to happen in an opening ball game. Remember, these football teams did not have a preseason. That's very important. This is their opening game.
The second clock is incorrect. There's only 9 seconds. Have delay penalty.
Game for the timekeeper, too. No delay.
And there's Honesty. Now, just keep your eye on that young man from Minnesota. If they don't move the ball a bit more, he's going to be in there.
Okay, so the clock was incorrect, but it showed that there had been no delay of game when, in fact, there was a delay of game. So make it first and 15 at the 40-yard line. Good catch. Number 86 is tight end out of Norwich University. And Baxley was there on the coverage, but Ricker made a nice diving catch.
Now watch the quarterback. Watch the middle linebacker particularly. He'll go to his left, and the tight end, Ricker, comes back to his right and makes a good diving catch. Notice the concentration. Landry's 5 for 6 for 82 yards.
There's Ricker, who replaced Tim Reitman in the starting lineup when Reitman went down with a knee injury. And there's the gun, which ends the first quarter. 15 minutes of United States Football League football has been played here in RFK Stadium, and George Allen's Chicago Blitz have a 7-0 lead over the Washington Federals. Second down, 6 yards to go for the Blitz as they run the first play of the second quarter. Tim Spencer with the football. He's clearly going to get a great deal of work. And now let's go down to Al Lerner on the field.
You were talking about that they had to dye some of the grass here. That's true. Even though the USFL is spring and summer football, we're starting in the winter, about 75 gallons of dye has been used on some of the winter burned out grass. The middle of the field has been re-sawed, and so there are special problems with football in the winter, spring and summer.
On that last carry, Spencer picked up 7 yards and a first down to the 21-yard line, and now Kevin Long is getting ruder treatment. Ronnie Este, number 55, was one of the tacklers there, along with Bob Schubert, backup linebacker from New Mexico.
You watch Este underneath the line there. Este is a 10-year veteran of Canadian football. He played at LSU, and he whips the lineman right there, drags him back. Outstanding play by the defense. The Feds have got to come up with a big play and stop him right here.
Let's give a little credit to number 70, Drew Taylor, too, who is playing in the fourth league of his pro career and penetrated from his defensive end position. Now on second down and 12 yards to go, Spencer is met hard by number 45, Bob Schubert, and the Blitz will be facing a passing situation.
If you notice that time, the quarterback called a trap play. That's a very good play on long yardage situations because the linemen come across the line of scrimmage and the offensive linemen can trap them. Good call. Not much yardage, but a good call.
Spencer now 9 carries, 39 yards in the game. And it is third down 10. They must get the football to the 11-yard line, actually well inside of it, to pick up a first down. Trumaine Johnson is on the near side of your screen. He's going instead to number 89, Lenny Willis, and Willis was overthrown in the end zone.
That time they had 3 receivers in. They had all 3 of their fastest men in, and they just ran them straight down the field. Landry just overthrew them.
Benny Smith put a little pressure on Landry and forced him to throw perhaps more quickly than he wanted to or before he'd gotten a good look at Willis. There's a good look at Greg Landry. He's always had the gray hair, incidentally.
Not always.
Well, almost always. Always as long as we've known him.
Very fine football player, and the difference between the teams right now.
So Corral will try a 37-yard field goal. Out of Cagle's hold, and the kick is wide to the right. So the Blitz miss an opportunity to expand their lead to 10-0. And with them still dominating the football game, Washington will take the football again when we come back. When the American Football League began in the early 60s, most of the quarterbacks in that league were journeyman backup type quarterbacks with NFL experience. Tim McQuilkin is another who fits that mold. He's mostly a backup quarterback during his years with the Falcons and the Redskins. In trouble. Ball is loose. Number 77 who hit McQuilkin was Junior IU. And Washington is able to recover the ball. I don't know if he is the man who actually came up with it.
You watch IU working on 69 Patton. Patton's his second year from Duke. IU, his coach, has played 10 years. That's the difference right there. Gets him from the blind side. Quarterback has no defense for that. Great fumble recovery by the quarterback right there. Kim McQuilkin showed you a little bit of pressure, a little bit of guts when he went after that football like that.
Loss of 12 yards on the play. Second down, 22. They got to get the ball all the way out to the 30 for a first down. James gets away from one man, but not two. 24, Virgil Livers forced him out of bounds. Number 28, Don Schwartz, the free safer, the strong safety, I should say, was the first man back there to put pressure on Craig James.
You know, Jim, it's obvious when you're watching a ball game that these young offensive linemen from the Feds are having a hard time with Lorch and Erman and Lathrop and Alu. All those guys have played. Erman's played 10 years. Alu has played 10 years. And there's three rookies on the offensive line of the Feds. That's the problem right now.
There's a look at Craig James. He has gone out of the ball game. Five defensive backs in the game now for the Blitz. The Feds face third down, 18 yards to go.
Right now, the fans are going to boo that call. Watch.
Well, I had James out of the ball game. Clearly, he was not, as he got the football. And the fans do, in fact, boo the call. Do you boo the call?
No, I've been down there before. They booed me a lot. But see, what that coach did that time was play safe to punt the ball. Third down and 18, they throw an interception, and they got a sure touchdown. I'm not saying these guys aren't going to block this one. They've come close every time the Blitz has on the Feds punt. And they're coming again.
Hoffman is kicking. Remember what a great knifing punt returner Eddie Brown was with the Redskins and the Rams? Eddie Brown is back at midfield. Ready to pick this one off.
They got the return on.
And Eddie's got a little seam, too. Inside the 40, down to the 38-yard line. Bob Schubert knocked him out of bounds there. But the Blitz will have excellent field position after the 36-yard punt by Hoffman. Played about 19 minutes in this game, and Chicago has had the ball for 14 of those 19 minutes. The Feds have had the ball four times and have yet to hold it more than a minute and a half. So now, Landry and the Blitz take control again at the 38-yard line of Washington, leading 7-0 already. Spencer just goes between tacklers for a few yards. Este was there.
Spencer from the I formation, like I mentioned before. There's Holensee warming up. Now, I'm not criticizing McQuilkin, but the problem is with McQuilkin, he doesn't have quick enough feet to get away from those gorillas that are chasing him down. Holensee is quicker, faster, and can avoid the rush, and that's why the coach is making the move.
The gain was a short two, so it's second down and a long eight. Wants to go deep. Overthrows Trumaine Johnson, and that one was thrown away.
What happened that time, the Feds faked a blitz, and Landry called it automatic and kept both backs in the block, but number two, Trumaine Johnson, did not hear the call. He was supposed to take off running and stop.
Number 70, Drew Taylor, put some pressure on Landry, who's now 5 of 8 in the ball game for 82 yards.
This is a perfect time for Coy Bacon to get after that quarterback.
Five defensive backs in the game. Baxter, the middle linebacker, comes out, and Mike Guest, 44, goes in as the nickelback for Washington. Federals are showing blitz, but they don't come. Landry throws it out in the flat, and Kevin Long makes a very alert catch. The defensive man was turned around. Greg Butler made the tackle, but Long was able to see the football and get out toward the sideline to get it.
All right, watch Bacon. Comes from the outside, and he comes to the inside. Good holding. Nice job. Then he gets double-teamed. He gets, watch Landry's reaction. Throws a quick shot. Long makes a great individual effort. Now, look, you can get up, remember, in professional football and run. Good play on the defense.
It was Schubert, the reserve linebacker, who had his back to the ball as Landry threw it. Number 92, Benny Smith, was in Landry's face. Another first down for the Blitz. Kevin Long with the ball, and Kevin Long is getting a new life in football in the United States Football League. Like so many other players, gets a gain of 4 before Coy Bacon brought him down.
It's interesting that the offensive line of Blitz is working so well together. There's 3 rookies on that ball club. Taylor, Stevenson, and Norman. 2 of them, I might add, from the Big Ten. Taylor from Northwestern, Norman from Illinois.
Second down, 6. Ball is just outside the 20. Trumaine Johnson.
Watch out.
We've seen this before, and he's down to the 4-yard line this time before Butler, number 28. 7-year veteran out of Howard, 3 times All-Canadian Football League.
Watch
the tackle.
The quarterback will fake. That makes number 50 stay in the middle. Now, all of a sudden, it's all over. 75's in middle of him. Trumaine Johnson better tuck that ball away, but he's a fine football player. I would say right now, just from watching this game, Trumaine Johnson could be one of the best players in America. Anywhere.
And because of the way they are playing him, that particular play is available all day long.
Absolutely.
So it's first and goal now. This is Kevin Long, and he scores. Second touchdown for the Blitz as Long goes in from 4 yards out. The Federals offered very little resistance on that drive.
Okay, now watch the quarterback hand the ball to him deep to Long. Now watch him make a quick break to the outside. You see, he was supposed to go over the middle, then cut to the outside, tucks the ball with 2 hands. We have a rule, 2 hands on the football until you score. That man has been well coached at South Carolina 5 years ago.
6 play drive, 38 yards. Took 3 minutes and 4 seconds. As Landry eased the blitz into the end zone. And now Corral will try to make it 14-0. He does. Now let's have another look.
All right, he gives the ball deep to Long. He's supposed to go off the left tackle, but he sees it crammed up, breaks to the outside. Now watch the 2 hands on the ball right now. That's beautiful coaching by his college coach.
It is 14-0 Chicago Blitz. Mike Hohensy warms up for the Federals. We'll be back. We are back in RFK Stadium for more than 8 minutes remaining before halftime. 44 Mike Guest on the right of the screen, 16 Reggie Smith on the left of the screen. Smith has caused a couple of anxious moments for the Blitz when he's gotten the ball into the open field. But those are about the only difficult moments that the Blitz have experienced in the entire first half. Corral hits this one pretty well, down to the 6-yard line, and here comes Mike Guest. Good job of kicking the ball away from Smith. Guest gets it out to the 26-yard line as Corral goes off. Again, Doak Field made the tackle downfield on the kickoff. He has made 3 special team tackles now. Blitz scoring drive, 6 plays, 38 yards, 3 minutes and 4 seconds. Kevin Long, who's a tough goal line runner, was with the Jets, was at South Carolina, got the ball into the end zone. Ball is at the 27, and it is still McQuilkin in the ball game for the Federals. McQuilkin, 2 of 5 for 25 yards. He's been sacked twice. Craig James, 3 tough yards against Joe Irman, one of the veterans on that Blitz defense. And now let's go down to Al Lerner, who's with Trumaine Johnson.
Trumaine, first pro game, you feel like a pro now?
Yes, I do. The team is really executing well. We're really putting out, and we're fired up, and we have the lead. We just hope we can.
Is there a better receiver on the field than you right now?
No.
Okay, thank you very much. Let's go back upstairs.
Four catches for 72 yards in the game so far for Trumaine. Eddie Robinson called him the best receiver he ever had at Grambling. That covers some ground. Wilkin on second down and eight. Overthrows the screen pass. He was trying to get it to Mark Brown, a rookie wide receiver. Carl Lorch and Joe Irman were the ones who were coming in hard on McQuilkin. Look at that, Lee.
It doesn't mean how long you get the ball. It's how, what you do with it after you get it. Now, the difference in the ball teams right now is the fact that the middle of the line of the feds cannot hold the middle of the line of the blitz away from the quarterback. That's why that coach called a screen to try to give the quarterback some confidence, but he threw the ball over the guy's head.
First downs in the ball game. Chicago has nine now. Washington has one. Buddy Hardiman and Joey Walters are both in. This throw was to Walters, and he was unable to get focused on it well enough to catch it. So, another kicking situation for the feds, and hey, it's tough when you get booed in the first half of your first ball game.
Well, the fans are just, they're on the quarterback, and they're on the coach, and they're on everybody, but that's basically because they paid 18 bucks a ticket. And if I paid 18 bucks a ticket, I might boo too.
Wayman Bugs, no. It is 89 Lenny Willis who is deep to receive again for the blitz. Apparently they're only going to use Brown in situations where they think they are going to get a good chance at a run back. Hoffman's kick is short. Willis makes the fair catch at the 44-yard line of Chicago. And again, they'll have excellent field position. This time Hoffman's punt was only 27 yards. So it's 14-0 Chicago. First down from the 44-yard line. Landry.
To Spencer. Spencer catches the ball right here, follows number 65, and goes down and makes a good block, and Trumaine Johnson even gets in the way of a guy. Not bad for a receiver.
Butler, the cornerback, was there along with Zupancic to run Spencer out of bounds, but not before he picked up 11 yards. Again, Spencer. Very close to 10 yards and another first down. Call it a gain of 9 down to the 35-yard line.
Okay, now watch the inside line. Watch the blitz trap and blow them off the ball. He's just smashing them off the ball, and he's just driving through people. That's Spencer's best game right smack at him, 11 times for 50 yards.
It wasn't always this easy for Greg Landry. Down two, actually a long one. Kevin Long trying to pick up the first down. May have fallen short. Five games in all being played today. Here's some scores from elsewhere around the league. Philadelphia leading Denver 7-0 in the second quarter. New Jersey on top of Los Angeles 9-6 in the second quarter. As you know, Herschel Walker already with a TD there. The Boston Breakers leading the Tampa Bay Bandits 17-14 in the fourth quarter. They did get a first down on the short run by Long, so now it is... veteran out of San Jose State knocked the pass down. He played in the World Football League. He played in the National Football League. He played in the Canadian Football League. Now he's in the U.S. Football League.
Quarterback drops back three steps. One, two, three, and throws. And the problem is he didn't get the ball over Taylor's hands, who jumps high and bats it down with his hand.
Now, Trumaine Johnson has returned to the lineup, replacing Lenny Willis on second down 10. Landry is looking at Johnson all the way. time he was unable to get free. Greg Butler, number 28, on the coverage. Johnson appears to work better on the other side against Brown.
Butler makes a great player, but I think basically what problem was, their protection was different that time. They did what we call a bootleg. They started one way and came back, and Trumaine could not beat that guy deep. Good play by Butler.
Now Willis is back in the ball game, replacing Trumaine Johnson. Check it, replacing Paul Ricker, the tight end. So now they have three wide receivers on third down and 10. Willis in the slot, Johnson is to the far side. Landry, and this is what he doesn't do well. He's doing all right here. He did hold on to the football and get back to the 33-yard line for a gain of 1 yard. Number 70, Drew Taylor was the man who got in there and chased him out of the pocket. 79, Coy Bacon got there too.
That's a great play by Coy Bacon. Drops back. Now watch the quarterback. He's got to try to hit the man across the middle, but this protection breaks down with Taylor. But now watch the effort on Coy Bacon right there. Come on, Coy! Yeah!
You gotta love him. Coy says he's 39 years old. Some people dispute that. And it's not that they're saying he's 36 or 37. We're looking more into the numbers in the 40s. But Coy says 39 years old. He's got the rap down. He knows that he was supposed to be born in 1944, and I believe it.
He's playing like he's 29.
Now Corral is going to try a 51-yard field goal, which is blocked.
There's the break.
Free ball. Mike Guess, 44, is the man who was chasing the football. Jeff Brown, 36, was there also. And the Federals will have good field position for one of the first times. Guess, 44, was the man who recovered it. Jeff Brown, number 36, was the one who blocked it.
That's a great inside rush by the left side. But you know what did that play? Coy Bacon's great play, stopping him, making them go for the field goal, forced that. Now, Coach Yock, now watch him. He's going to come through here, but they come from the right side. He'll dive, tip it, right there.
And now Mike Hohenze has come into the ball game for the Federals, so the crowd comes to life. Craig James on first down, picks up 3 yards, and already with Hohenze in the ball game, the offensive line seemed to fire off the ball better than they have before.
Well, you know, it's always like that, and there's no reflection on the quarterbacks or the coaches, but they're always second-guessing everybody. But in this situation, they needed something. Obviously, they weren't moving the football. The coach did a smart thing by making the move.
17, Joey Walters in the game at wide receiver, replacing Reggie Smith. Federal coaches expect him to be their number one receiver sometime. He's only been around 3 days. Hohenze wants to go deep. 83 was Mark Brown. 24 on the coverage was Virgil Livers. The fans want a pass interference call against Livers. Stan White wants a pass interference call in the opposite direction against Brown.
Hohenze round up and throw it long there. You know, Hohenze's rap. Now watch this kid run. Mark Brown gets down, he breaks a little bit to his outside, and he starts running. It's called a fly pattern. He's taller than Livers, and that's what they're trying to do, get the tall man on the short man, but it's pretty good pass defense. Territorial rights.
Now on third and 7, Buddy Hardeman is in the game for Mayberry. Hohenze gets a little time, but overthrows on the out pattern, trying to hit Joey Wolf.
You notice what they did that time, Jim, which was very smart. They brought Hohenze half roll. In other words, they brought him away from the middle of the pocket. The reason is he's not very tall, and he can't see over the linemen.
The Federals have had 6 third down situations, have yet to convert one into a first down. And rather than attempt a field goal from all the way out here at the 42, which would have to be about a 59-yarder, Steve Hoffman is on. Willis, 89, and 25, Eddie Brown, are both deep this time. Hoffman, 31.3 yards only on his kicks so far in the game. And again, Willis makes the fair catch, this time back at the 11-yard line on a 32-yard punt, which turns out to be very effective. It's 14-0 Chicago.
Quarterback out of UCLA has replaced Mike Ray, and he has 2 consecutive completions. This one goes out to Tony Bodie, and it puts the LA Express out on top. They lead 13-9. They got the conversion. The LA Express has come back under the arm of Tom Ramsey. Back to you.
Back in RFK Stadium. Those Los Angeles Express uniforms remind you of anything you've seen before, Lee?
It looks like Oakland, doesn't it?
A little like Oakland, a little like the Cowboys when they're in their dark blue jerseys, too, with all that silver and dark. Now the Blitz will start from their own 11-yard line. In their previous possessions, they were always in great field position, starting two of them in the Federals' territory and the rest outside their 40. First down, Spencer gets about 8 yards out to the 19. Got around the corner. Jeff Brown chased him out of bounds.
Hey, Jim, you know, and it's interesting. That play there was almost exactly the same play. Remember that they ran against Ohio State, ran against Michigan that you had on the beginning of the show? Makes a great play.
Remember Obed Ariri? That was him, number one. Broke some NCAA records while kicking for Clemson.
He might break one here standing the longest.
It's second down two after Spencer's 8-yard gain on first down. Now Kevin Long goes the other way. And Long is met and dropped short of a first down by Ronnie Este and John Zupancic. Here it is 14-0 Chicago in Los Angeles. The Los Angeles Express lead the New Jersey Generals and Herschel Walker 13-9. Number 84 Cozen in the ballgame now at tight end, as they will go with two tight ends on third down and about a yard. Long has been getting the short yardage. And it is Long again, who busts across the 20 to the 23-yard line for a blitz first down before Ed Baxley made the stop.
Total offense, Chicago 200, Washington 24.
Football is at the 24-yard line. Chicago Blitz under George Allen, playing as well as so many people expected them to in this game, have completely dominated it. Blitz, of course, will be in the Central Division of the United States Football League as we get the two-minute warning now, 2 minutes to go before halftime. So when we return to RFK Stadium, there'll be 2 minutes left in the half. It's 14-0 Chicago. You see Craig James, who is now on the sidelines, as the Washington Federals play defense against the Chicago Blitz. The Blitz with a first down at their 24-yard line in a half they have completely dominated. James' rushing statistics reflect the futility of the Washington offense so far. Those 18 yards represent 18 of the 24 yards they have gained in the ballgame.
And they have not been easy yards.
Trumaine Johnson is to the far side. Wayman Bugs is in the slot. Long has the football, and Long is across the 25 and close to the 30-yard line. He has great leg drive straight ahead.
He's strong. That's a very conservative call, isn't it? You're ahead 14-0, you got the other team in around, and you run right smack up the middle.
George has never been thought of as a flamboyant offensive strategy.
He might be trying to go in 14-0, which wouldn't be too bad, particularly when he's playing such good defense up front.
Long 10 carries for 32 yards. You know, throughout his career, a typical George Allen blowout is not of the 45-0 variety, but rather when you beat a team like 22-3 and hold them to 7 or 8 first downs and get 5 or 6 turnovers. Spencer on first down has big yardage, and this may give him the room to try a little bit as they go out to the 39-yard line. Now, here's a new USFL rule. Just as in college football throughout a ball game, here only in the last 2 minutes of each half a first down stops the clock. So when you gain a first down on a running play like that, unlike in the NFL if you're working the 2-minute drill, meanwhile the clock on the screen runs just to show that I'm dead wrong. Well, the first down was supposed to stop the clock.
It stopped, and then it starts when they set the screen.
All right.
Oh, watch that play. Beautiful.
Trumaine Johnson again.
Uh-oh.
He is to the 39-yard line of Washington. Donnie Harris made the stop, which saved a touchdown. But so far, the Federals have no way of covering Trumaine Johnson.
Now, he goes on about 15 yards here. They fake the screen, and then he looks for the ball. Watch. I tell you what, I don't know how much they paid that guy, but they didn't pay him enough.
On first down, Landry throws over the head of Trumaine Johnson. So that'll make it second down, 10. There are 43 seconds now left in the half.
That play was designed to throw a sideline pass to Johnson. If he was not open, throw it out of bounds and stop the clock. Very good strategy. That's Charlie Waller, the offensive coordinator, telling Willis what he wants done.
Charlie Waller, who was himself once a head coach in the National Football League,
and also at Clemson.
Used to coach the San Diego Chargers. Second down, 10. Interesting call as he gets down to the 35-yard line. Now the Blitz call a timeout to stop the clock. They'll have third down and 4. Ed Baxley made the stop in his middle linebacker position. So with 37 seconds left before the half, and the Blitz leading 14-0, we'll be back. There's a look at Ray Yock, who is formerly the coach of the Winnipeg Blue Bombers. Before that, he coached in Edmonton in the CFL. And the Blitz, who are 6 of 9 on third down situations so far in the ball game, have 3rd and 4. Ball at the 33. Landry wants to throw to Trumaine Johnson again, and this time Johnson ran a different pattern than the one that Landry was anticipating.
They try to run Trumaine Johnson straight up the field, and then we're going to run a sideline cut, but he just didn't get the signal straight. It's fourth down. It's going to be an interesting call here.
Well, I don't think they're going to try a field goal again because, frankly, no, he had Corral kicking from 51 or 52 yards. He was beyond his range anyway.
Plus, the coach figured they blocked the last one. He didn't want to get into that situation, have him block it, pick it up, score, and go in with momentum.
Three wide receivers in the ballgame. Johnson is to the far side. Lenny Willis and Wayman Bugs to the near side. Good throw. He hit Willis down the middle. He has a first down at the 22-yard line. Mike Guest, the nickelback, made the stop. Ohio State tackling Ohio State.
Now watch him, that they have two receivers going down the field. Willis will just find an open spot, gets one-on-one coverage, delivers the ball. That's a timing cut. Makes a good play there. That's Ohio State tackling Ohio State. Woody would be proud of those guys, wouldn't he?
Woody is proud of those guys.
He's proud of all his men. Not only those, all those others that graduated and are now making a great career.
A lot of people are going to be tempted to say, on the basis of what they've seen here in this first half, that Allen, the known quantity, has horsewhipped Ray Yock, the Canadian coach whom they don't know. That isn't really the case.
Let me tell you what, if Allen came on this side and Yock went on that side, Yock would win. The guys in the red have a better football team right now than the guys in the white. The Chicago Blitz are a fine football team. They're well-schooled. They got some nice veterans. Coach Yock's got one problem. He's got to try to get out of this without going in there 21-0, because that really puts a lot of pressure on him.
There is nothing that Yock can do other than to hope his defense is going to be able to resist Chicago here with 25 seconds left on the clock. He marked the ball out at the 23. Trumaine Johnson is to the far side, and again, with three wide receivers in the game, Willis and Bugs are to the near side.
Here they come.
The blitz got through, and Johnson gets a touchdown anyway.
Geez.
What a catch. No flag, no call of offensive interference, which the defensive backs for the Federals might have been looking for. Donnie Harris was there, as was Butler. Johnson took the ball away.
There's absolutely nothing you can do about this. Butler's a 7-year pro. Trumaine runs in and runs a corner route, and from then on, it's athletic ability. Now, watch the concentration. Oh, I don't know what Herschel Walker got, but this guy's better than Herschel Walker. I'm telling you.
Well, I bet you.
This guy's unbelievable.
There's another look. There's a touchdown pass from Landry to Trumaine Johnson. Look at that. He almost lost the football and got it back. That's a remarkable play.
That's a remarkable player.
And the extra extra point by Corral is good. It is 21-0 Chicago. Trumaine Johnson, under the coaching of George Allen, in this first half, Trumaine Johnson has six catches for 116 yards.
See what Herschel Walker's got.
Well, he's not catching the ball way down the field.
I know. That's why I said this guy is a great football player. I mean, I don't care what league you're talking about. You know, Jim, you can see natural great ability in that kid. Now, watch this exceptional play here. And, you know, you could be critical of the defensive back, but he's playing his error pretty well. All right, a quarterback's getting rushed. Now, watch. He knows the spot that he's going to be in. He just throws it. Oh, man. You think Eddie Robinson's proud of that? Has to be.
Meanwhile, Landry, with the pleasure of throwing to Trumaine Johnson, has stats of 11 of 18 for 177 yards.
I'd be interested to know who else has caught the ball.
Reggie Smith and Mike Guess are back to receive the kick from Corral. Landry has actually spread the ball around to one, two, three, four, five, six different receivers, but Johnson has six catches and the other five guys have one apiece. Reggie Smith, he's got some room. Out to the 41-yard line. It seems that Corral was in on the tackle along with Doug Cozen. Corral's a big physical guy. He can get out there and muscle with you a little bit.
But I guarantee it's 21-0. I wouldn't want my guy in there then.
Scoring drive for the Blitz that time, 89 yards, their longest drive of the ball game, 11 plays, time of possession, 3 minutes and 6 seconds, and Johnson got the touchdown. So the Federals with 3 wide receivers and 14 seconds on the clock try to hoist one up. Instead it is the screen. Buddy Hardeman has the football. Cohen's, he is still in the game. Stan White, first time we've given him a call on a tackle. 33 years old, 11-year veteran out of Ohio State, played with the Colts and the Lions, made the tackle for Chicago.
Now you might wonder why that quarterback threw that play and called it. The reason, simple reason, it was a completion, right? He's got to go into the dressing room. Coach Yock's problem right now is behind. He thinks the other team might be better physically, and he's got to do some things different in that dressing room and try to trick them a little bit, or else these guys are going to run right off the field. The Blitz is a good football team, and I don't care what level of professional football.
You know what's interesting, Lee? Unlike what we've seen from many George Allen teams in the past, they have done this today, defensively dominated the Federals while playing pretty much plain vanilla on defense.
Absolutely.
Not a lot of blitzing, not much gambling.
Good observation, Jim. Just because they're better. Why mess around?
Second down, 7 yards to go after the 3-yard gain. This will be the last play of the half. Joey Walters is down there. And Minifield had him covered all the way. So, the half ends in futility for Washington. Something they experienced throughout the half. And you see Ray Yock heading for the dressing room. He's got a lot to talk about. Much work ahead of him. Meanwhile, George Allen has had the kind of first half that a lot of people suspected he and his team might. They scored 3 times. In some ways, it could have been worse. Al Lerner from WLOS LSTV is with him right now.
Well, so far it is. They got a sign up there that kind of riled me up a little bit. They said George Allen doesn't win here anymore. I guess they've forgotten.
You prove it again. The good offense starts with good defense.
Right. Well, we still got 30 minutes to play, and we have to improve our special teams. Our special teams didn't do a good job.
That's the only area you're unhappy with?
That's the only area. We'll straighten that up.
This is Al Lerner in Washington with Washington Federals coach Ray Yock. You're trailing 21-0. What can you tell your team that changes things, that could change their mindset getting ready for the second half?
Well, maybe a quick kick and wait for a break. I don't know. Chicago played well in the first half and made some big catches, made some big plays, and we just got our people to settle down. They're a little excited and get them to settle down and play football.
What in your game plan specifically do you have to change to change this tide for you?
Well, we got to stop Chicago and we've got to start moving the football. We haven't done that, and I hope Hohensee will be able to go in there this half and do a good job.
Hohensee will start the second half.
Yes, he will.
All right. Are you disconsolate right now?
No. I'm just trying to get back to the bench. That's
okay,
all.
I will let you.
Okay,
thank you very much, Ray. Back to you, Jim and Lee.
Thanks a lot, Al, and thanks to Ray Yock for taking the time to spend a moment with us. The Blitz will be starting with the football or at least receiving the kickoff as the second half begins. And the rain, I think, is beginning to fall again. It is indeed. So the field is probably going to get a little bit wetter as we go along. A couple of observations on the first half, Lee. Mark of the Federals' futility on offense. None of their possessions, and they had seven of them, lasted more than 1.5 minutes. So they couldn't sustain anything at all. I said early in the ballgame that Landry is not regarded as a mobile quarterback, but I'm a little surprised at his footwork. He was only sacked once, despite being under pressure several times. That's been a factor in his success.
I think his experience, I think his ability, he's played so long, he has a good feeling about himself, and I think that one of the interesting statistics right there, the team that runs the football usually wins 80% of the football games. So they're controlling the line of scrimmage with 101 yards rushing compared to 19. Forget the passing yardage, look at that rushing yardage, and you can find a winner most of the time.
15 first downs to 1, 271 total yards to 27. I don't know when I've seen a half more dominated by one team. Jim Stone, number 42 out of Notre Dame, has the football for the blitz. And Stone gets it across the 30 to the 33-yard line before Mike Hurst, reserve defensive back, made the stop. 23-yard run back for Jim Stone. And the blitz will bring the same offense onto the field. We will be looking for Landry, number 11, Wayman Bugs, 88, and Trumaine Johnson, 2, are the wide receivers, and they are both in the ball game. The tight end is Paul Ricker, 86, and the backs are Kevin Long, 48, and Tim Spencer, 46. Ricker comes in motion. Long has the football, and a pickup of a long two, maybe a short three, before Ron Este made the stop. Those are the people I just mentioned, Landry, Spencer, Long, who's had a surprisingly good first half. The line, Ricker, Taylor, Stevenson, Pursuit, Norman, and Ayer. And there's really neither one of those two sides that Allen and his staff regard as significantly stronger than the other. They could go either direction on short yardage situations. Landry's stats in the first half, and as I said in the first half, it hasn't always been this easy for Greg Landry, who had some rocky moments in the NFL. Blitz gets to Landry. The ball did not come loose. It was Bob Schubert who burst through the gap and nailed Landry. But Landry was able to hand the football off.
They were trying a trap play that time, and the linebacker blitzed. Now, this is all part of something different the coach has to do. Blitz more.
There's the defense for the Federals. Drew Taylor had a pretty good first half. Boy Bacon got in there a couple of times, showed that he can still move. Maxley was far and away the leading tackler from his middle linebacker position. Jeff Brown and Greg Butler are the men who are going to have to try to do something about Trumaine Johnson in this half. On third down, the nickelback, Mike Guess, is in the game. And Spencer has the first down as the Blitz continue their methodical precision on third down plays out to the 47-yard line, a first down before Schubert made the tackle. 13-yard gain.
Now watch Spencer come out of the back. He checks his linebacker and he comes out. You wonder why he's so deep. There's two guys on Trumaine Johnson. That's why. Nice catch. Catches the ball. Breaks the tackle. I'm very impressed with 45, Schubert. He's made about 70% of the tackles in the clutch situations. Number 45.
Schubert is a first-year pro out of New Mexico. On first down, Landry wants Trumaine Johnson and has short game as Johnson was coming back for the ball. Greg Butler dragged him down, number 28. He's been getting quite a workout.
Butler,
pick up a five, Lee. Go ahead.
Butler's got a problem, see, because every time Johnson runs down there, he's been beating him deep, right? So he gives him a lot of room, all of a sudden he stops and he throws the ball in front of him. Great timing.
It will be second down, a long five. Gave up about 4 yards after he caught the ball. Crowd cheers for the Federals cheerleaders who are circling the field. Landry, under pressure again, gets the ball away down the middle. That's the tight end Paul Ricker, who has the first down in Washington territory inside the 40.
Ricker is so wide open, he looks like he popped out of the ground. And the reason why he was open is they double-covered both of the wideouts, the high-priced guys, and left the Ricker right in the middle, wide open. That's a tough philosophy. You put both guys outside deep and hook that middle guy in the middle from Norwich. Where's that?
Football factory. First down. down 10. Trumaine.
Watch out.
Third time today they've used the play. Third time today it has worked for good yardage. Butler made the tackle, but not before Johnson picked up another Chicago first down at the 25-yard line.
Now watch, they change his play a little bit. They faked and threw the guy the ball, Johnson, and he comes up behind the linemen who make great plays. Now, you know what they did different that time? They put a man in motion. Very interesting strategy. Put a man in motion, left that guy out, Butler, by himself. Boy, that's tough. Two steps up, gets the ball, Trumaine, 75's coming out there, Taylor. The guy from Northwestern makes a good block. Trumaine Johnson's a dynamite player.
8 catches now for 131 yards for Trumaine Johnson.
9.
That time, a pretty good play by Butler and 26, Donnie Harris, who got over to help out. Here's Greg Butler, 27 years old. Big-time cornerback in Canadian Football League.
There's a timing play, throws the ball to the corner. Butler's got 7 years' experience, and that's why he makes a great play here. He looks up at the last minute. Deflection. Trumaine Johnson is human. He missed one.
This time Johnson is to the far side on second down 10. This is Kevin Long. Down as Long gets about 5 yards down inside the 20-yard line. Donnie Harris made the stop for the Federals. Holding. Call which really helps the Washington Federals at this point. They need some kind of opportunity to tee off and put pressure on Landry and try to get the blitz out of field goal range.
I'm not sure, but I believe this is about the first major penalty that the Blitz has had. They've been playing very, very well for a first ball game.
10-yard penalty moves the ball to the 32-yard line, and now it will be second down 20 from there. No penalties so far for the Federals. They've been perfect in that area. The Blitz, 4 penalties for 25 yards in the ball game. We haven't seen one of the new pass interference calls. Landry's going to go down. And now they're out of field goal range. Number 55, Ronnie Este. A real pro. 31 years old, 10-year veteran out of LSU.
He plays with great enthusiasm. That's why I like him. Let all those Tigers play like that down in Bayou Country. Awful good pass rusher.
Spent most of his career in the Canadian Football League, was a big star at Edmonton under the coaching of Ray York.
He's not very tall. You notice he's about 6'2", but he's a very, very fine pass rusher because of his great attitude and the hustle.
That height is no doubt the reason he wound up in Canada instead of in the NFL.
Absolutely.
Trumaine Johnson back in the game. Kevin Long. Third down gets only a couple, and the Federals have managed to stop a blitz drive. Bob Schubert, number 45, who, as you said, makes a lot of clutch tackles, was there along with 50 Ed Baxley.
Schubert's playing because I think Supanik's been hurt. I haven't seen him play much lately, and I saw him working on his shoulder down there before.
Supanik came into the game being bothered by a bruised thigh.
Okay, he's out from Miami of Ohio, and that's why
Schubert's gotten an opportunity to play, and has
made
something of it.
This is an interesting call here. They're on the 35-yard line, and they're going to punt it.
There are three men back in receiving position for the Federals.
You want to bet a nickel they take a penalty? That goes to show you what I know.
Just to show you what I know, I didn't take the bet. Corral hits it into the end zone. The ball will come out to the 20.
You know, if he'd have taken a penalty, that'd have been on the one.
So, Washington will have its first possession of the second half with the ball at their own 20 when we come back. Washington trails 21-0, and we are about to learn whether they have come up with some adjustments on offense at halftime, which will enable them to move the football after a one first down first half against Allen's defense. Mike Hohensee still in the game at quarterback, and he throws complete to Craig James. Well, one thing we know, James is going to be a pretty good receiver.
He's very good coming out of the backfield, Jim. Now here's Hohensee. urgency coming in a ball game, and everybody's juiced up. But it isn't only him. It's that line protection. Hohensee played in Minnesota. I coached against him.
There's a mark of how much Craig James is going to be carrying in terms of responsibility this year for the Federals. The only man to have lugged the football today for the Federals offense. Walters to the far side. That is where Hohensee looks as he rolls. Instead, it was Reggie Smith he was trying to hit. And the pass was too high for Smith. Frankly, most of them are.
Smith's very short, but he runs good patterns. He run an out pattern right there, and they rolled Hohensee out. The reason why a quarterback is rolling out like that, he's not very tall, and therefore he can't see over the linemen, so he sees around them. Hohensee has been behind at Minnesota before and can bring a team back, so don't leave.
As one who coached against him in the Big Ten, what are his primary characteristics? I mean, his biggest attributes as a quarterback?
Competitiveness. Watch him come back.
Third down, 4 yards to go. Under pressure, Hohensee misses. Hard to tell whether he was looking for James or for Mark Brown. I'm going to guess Mark Brown. Either way, it was incomplete. Kit Lathrop, number 70, was the man who was in Hohensee's face as he tried to deliver the ball. So the Federals do just about as well on offense the first time in the second half as they did throughout the first half, picking up 6 yards but no first down. There's Lenny Willis out of Ohio State, who is deep to receive this kick from Steve Hoffman. Longest kick in the ball game, 37 yards. Wonder if this smaller ball is significantly harder to punt. Frank Corral told me that it's much harder to keep on line, he thinks, on place kicks.
I think it depends on what kind of a strong leg you got.
Willis is going to run this one back.
Watch out.
Special teams have always been a trademark of George Allen's teams. He didn't like the way they played in the first half. This time they're off to a good start. 15-yard return on a 32-yard punt. We'll be back. We've got 8 minutes and 50 seconds left in the third quarter of this football game, with the Blitz leading 21-0. In the first half, they had great field position on all of their possessions, which they were able to utilize to create this lopsided margin in first downs. And the pattern repeats. They start this first possession of the second half at the Washington Federals 44-yard line. Second possession of the second half, I should say. This time Landry throws the ball right into the hands of Doug Green, the strong safety out of Texas A&I, and Doug Green couldn't hold on. Drew Taylor was putting pressure on Landry, who could find no receiver, threw the ball away down the middle.
Watch, they fake Spencer, but they get a good pass rush there by Taylor. He whips, the man comes back, and there's 45, Schubert again. I think he was shocked at the ball. He threw the ball to him. I don't think Green had any idea.
Well, he was trying to turn his body around a little bit backwards to get to the football and just couldn't get his hands on it.
Did you notice Schubert back in there again? 206 pounds.
Spencer is going to be swarmed under on the outside as the Federals' defense begins to look a little bit more aggressive. And now, with Chicago leading here 21-0, let's go to Frank Gifford in New York.
Thank you, Jan. The LA Express making it tough on the New Jersey Generals. Tom Ramsey replaced Mike Ray in the second quarter. This is his second touchdown pass of the game, going out to Vister Hayes. Vister Hayes obviously had little or no coverage on that. He gets in to make it 20-9. Herschel Walker on the day, 12 attempts, 46 yards. Back to you, Lance.
Spencer out of the ball game now here at RFK Stadium, and Doug Dennison, number 21, is in for the first time. You might remember him with the Dallas Cowboys. Trumaine Johnson is to the top of your screen. That's where Landry is looking. Now he's under pressure. Ronnie Este was there, and so was 79 Foy Bacon. Well, Foy Bacon is fun to watch. He's going to give the Federals fans thrills here this year, just as he gave Redskins fans a thrill playing for Washington.
All right, here's Esty, a 10-year veteran, and there's Bacon, a 15-year veteran. Between these two guys, that's 25 years of football, and it shows right there. Esty misses him, grabs him, and then 79 Bacon jumps on top. Those two guys are playing wonderful football, but I tell you what, they can't play any better as long as they've been playing. They've got to get tired sooner or later.
16 is Reggie Smith. 22 is Buddy Hardiman as they wait for the punt from Corral. He gets it away. A low liner, which is going to go out of bounds at the 18-yard line of Washington. So that'll be an effective 42-yard kick for Frank Corral. And the Federals will begin again with poor field position when we come back. In RFK Stadium in Washington, where the favored Chicago Blitz are leading 21-0 over the Washington Federals. The Federals have looked a little bit feistier, particularly on defense here in the third quarter. They still have yet to do anything on offense. Mike Hohensey, rookie from Minnesota. Calls the count. This is Craig James. James has about four tough yards. One of the two star rookie running backs in this game, and Al Lerner is with the other one, Tim Spencer.
Is he unhappy that you're not coming out and throwing more points on the board early?
No, he just said that we're going to go back to basics and do what we do best and get our running game and our passing game together, and that's about what he said.
They're proud that you're Ohio State right now, you think?
Pardon me?
They're proud of you at Ohio State right now?
I don't know. I hope so. I hope they're proud of our whole team.
Okay, thank you very much.
In case you're wondering, Spencer says that he is headed back to Ohio State this summer to continue progress toward his degree. Again, Craig James with the football. He continues to be the only Washington Federal ball carrier who has carried the ball from scrimmage today. This time he got about three. Junior IU, number 77, made the tackle.
You might wonder why Coach Yock is running the football at those people with a 21-0 deficit. The reason he is doing that is to keep that pass rush down. He's got to keep those linemen off his quarterback, Hohensey. This man's a good football coach, and he's coached a long time. He knows what he's doing.
Third and three for the Feds, who are 0-7, or 0-4-7, I should say, on third down. Haven't gotten a first down since the first quarter. James is going to carry the football, and the crowd goes bonkers for the Federals' second first down of the ball game. Maurice Tyler, number 20, the backup cornerback, whom you may remember from his NFL days, came up to make the stop. Craig James, on his 11th carry, picks up the second first down of the game for Washington.
They ran the ball three times. That was good strategy, and Craig James made great movement, but has tremendous speed to get to the outside. I think Minifield has been out, number one, and they're playing Tyler more defensive corner, aren't they?
That is, in fact, the case. Minifield has not been in the ball game. We are now told that Minifield has a dislocated knee. This time, Craig James gets a rude greeting from Kip Lathrop at the line of scrimmage, and it'll be second down 10. A look at the Washington Federals bench. The uniform is not green and black because that is the color on the dollar. It is green and black because that is the color of Beryl Bernard's yacht. He is the owner of the ball club. The Blitz, incidentally, just for the record, are owned by Dr. Ted Dietrich, a man named Willard Harris, who is a construction magnate in Southern California, and George Allen, part owner of the ball club. Buddy Hardiman in on second down 10. The pass is complete to Mark Brown, and Brown is out to the 46-yard line for a 17-yard gain and another Federal first down, and that represents the most potent offensive output of the day by Washington.
And now watch Brown. He'll go out about 10 yards and slow down. Now, if you'll see, he makes a little kind of a fake like he was going to go down. It's a delay pattern. He's coming underneath the clear man, makes good concentration, breaks a tackle there, and goes far. That's great. Great play by Mark Brown.
And on first down, Hardiman comes back into the ballgame. Or check it. Mayberry goes back into the ballgame replacing Hardiman. James is hit right at the line of scrimmage and continues to get rough work. Kit Lathrop again, number 70, rookie out of Arizona State, was the man who made the stop. Interestingly, despite the Blitz affection for, or the Blitz coaching staff's affection for veteran ball players, with Joe Irman and Carl Lorch and Junior IU, a few graybeards along the front four, their coaches said that Kit Lathrop, the rookie, had actually been the most impressive of their defensive linemen in training camp.
Absolutely, a rookie from Arizona State, played for Darrell Rogers.
Second down 10. Walters is to the far side, number 17. Hohensey has James open but doesn't want to throw to him. Now he throws back across, and Joey Walters has another first down for Washington, although a flag has gone down.
They might call an offensive lineman downfield.
Lathrop was the man who forced Hohensee out of the pocket on that play. And it is going to be offensive holding. The hands call would have been a pickup of more than 10 yards, but it's apparently going to be nullified by a penalty against Washington. First penalty of the ball game against the Federals.
Hohensee will roll out. Now you see why I was talking about his height. He rolls out to the right. He's getting good pressure. There's Baxley in the middle. He's directing, and this is what he does best of all. Picks up the second receiver, throws it back. Great play right there. They call illegal use of the hands. And that's Joey Walter, the Canadian that just come into the club. He's going to be a fine football player also.
Illegal hands by the offense. Second down.
Usually that means that an offensive lineman pushed a defensive lineman, extending his hand straight out.
The penalty moves the ball back to the Washington 45, where it will be second down 11. Eddie Brown is in the ball game as defensive back. Blitz. Hohensee got away and now is going to be dropped. 77 junior IU tackled Hohensee from behind. It was 56 Ed Smith who was on the blitz.
Watch junior IU right at number 77. He's a 10-year veteran from Arizona State. He starts to the outside, sees a quarterback, but watch his quickness right there. Boy, he's a lean, good-looking football player. Junior IU, number 77 from Arizona State, and a 10-year veteran. Professional football.
12 years ago, he had a great game for Arizona State in a Peach Bowl blizzard win against North Carolina. He had a lot of great games in the Canadian Football League. Third down now for the Federals. Hohensee gets toward the sideline, throws back down the middle again, looking for Joey Walters, but this time he threw behind him. Walters was pretty well covered by Ed Smith.
That time the offensive line did a nice job, except the blitz used a twist. One man went one of the area, and the other one come back and took his place, and they chased that poor Hohensee for his life. I don't know how much he gets paid, but he don't get paid enough for being out there getting chased like that. Oh.
Lenny Willis is now deep to receive, and Steve Hoffman is back to punt the ball away for Washington as they try to pin the blitz deep in their territory for one of the first times all day. The fair catch and makes it at the 18-yard line. So, out in Los Angeles, the LA Express are beating the New Jersey Generals. Here in Washington, the Blitz are beating the Chicago Federals. Washington Federals, and we'll be back. The clock shows you the time remaining in the third quarter in RFK Stadium as Greg Landry and the Chicago Blitz offense come up to the line of scrimmage. First down, following a punt, balls at the 18-yard line of Chicago. The give is to Tim Spencer, and Spencer shows some nifty feet and picking up about 5 yards. You're always looking for somebody short to interview on the sidelines, and Al Lerner has found someone.
This is Reggie Smith of the Federals, the smallest man on the field at 5'4", but yet you've had a pass reception today. You think they have to go more to you to get back in the game?
I think so, because the way they're playing over there on my side, I'm open most on every pattern that we ran so far, and hopefully that we'll start throwing on my side again.
Okay, I'll tell Ray Yock right now. Thanks, Reggie.
I think we can probably safely assume that Reggie will do something to pass that information along. Second down 3. They gave Spencer 7 yards on the first play. This time he's wrapped up out there on the corner on an excellent open field tackle by Doug Green. Played with the Cardinals and the Bills.
That's one of his favorite plays from Ohio State. It's called a toss sweep that USC made famous. They just put everybody in front of him, and he tries to find daylight. But that Green came up real well, made a hard tackle high, made a great play. But you know what Reggie says? Every receiver on every pass play says they're open. You ever had a fail?
Nature of the beast. Trumaine Johnson this time to the near side. Bugs is in the slot. 3rd and 2. Give to Kevin Long, and this time he is wrapped up. That is becoming a bit predictable because Long had gotten
That's
the call
right.
on every short yardage play all day. This time, Ronnie Este and Coy Bacon made the play.
Notice Este and Bacon are the guys making the big plays for him. That's experience, and that's what you expect from those two guys, and good leadership. You know what's happened to the Blitz? It happens a lot. They get ahead 21-0, and they kind of go to sleep. You notice they don't have that quite, Jim, they don't have that intensity, that zip to them yet.
There's Frank Corral. The man in the middle at the right of your screen is Reggie Smith, who has provided a few of the very few moments of excitement for Washington today. Good kick by Corral. Drives Smith back inside his 30 to the 29. But he's got some room.
Oh!
Good tackle.
Nice try.
Excellent saving tackle in the open field by 42 Jim Stone. Then the flag went down after another Chicago player put the hit on Smith. So we'll wait to see what the penalty call is as Reggie Smith collects his bearings and heads back to the sideline.
It's either clipping or blocking below the waist. You know they have a rule in this league that you cannot block on kicks below the waist. That's done for the safety of the football players, and it's an excellent rule. There's so many knee injuries by blocking below the waist, they eliminate most of them with that simple rule right there.
It has long been said that an enormously high proportion of the injuries, particularly the serious injuries in football, come on kicking plays, special teams plays. Do you think it's still true to such a dramatic degree, Lee?
Yes, I think it is. And basically, it's because of that rule that they used to be able to block below the waist. Now, see, with this elimination, that team blocks higher, there's less knee injuries.
Personal foul, flipping during the run back. First down.
On the play, the third quarter expired. So you're watching another exclusive of ABC Sports. That's the end of the third quarter, 21-0. We'll return for the fourth after this message and a word for our local station.
Dick Bilski is the offensive coordinator. You notice he's getting the information from upstairs and calling the plays from the sideline.
Was a star at Maryland in College Park, very close to here in his collegiate playing days 28 years ago under Jim Tatum. Owensy's pass is batted into the air. 71 Carl Lorch, an old George Allen favorite, was there to tip it up. Lorch, 32 years old, six-year veteran out of Southern Cal. He was one of the players on Allen's Washington Redskin teams, and now here he is back with Allen and the Blitz. There are the third quarter stats. Not much change.
Again, that major statistic, 106 yards rushing to 29. If you cannot control the line of scrimmage running the football, it puts too much pressure on the pass protection.
Eddie Brown played it perfectly along with Ed Smith, the outside linebacker. And there is the first completed game in the United States Football League. Steve Spurrier's Tampa Bay Bandits pulling out a victory over the Boston Breakers. Spurrier has his first win ever as a head coach. Tampa Bay is off to a successful start. In the Central Division with the Chicago Blitz. Boston Breakers are in the Atlantic Division with the Washington Federals. Craig James was slowed down enough by Eddie Brown that the rest of the Blitz defense was able to react and get there and prevent him from picking up first down yardage. Junior IU was in on the tackle, so was Ed Smith. But that will bring up another kicking situation for the Federals, and this time Hoffman will have to stand back at about his 10. Lenny Willis, who has been the punt returner for the Blitz on all but a couple of occasions, is back alone, and it looks like they're going to go for the block again. Minifield, the hot man number one, who was coming close before, is out of the ball game with a dislocated knee. They didn't go for the block. Instead, they're setting up the return. Willis doesn't call the fair catch, and he pays for it. Number 24, Willie Holly, backup cornerback, goes downfield to hit him. 37-yard punt by Hoffman, and a return of zero by Lenny Willis. And with 13:15 to go in the ball game, and the Blitz leading 21-0, we'll be back. There are the numbers on Greg Landry. in his first USFL game. Did I say Gleg? I meant Greg, of course. And he will start the blitz offense now. First down 10 from the 39-yard line. Spencer is out of the ball game. The running backs are 21 Doug Dennison and 42 Jim Stone. We get a new backfield. This is Stone. His first carry. Pickup of 8 yards before John Supancic, number 51, who's back in the ball game after a long rest, made the stop.
All right, with a 21-0 lead, this is a good opportunity to get Stone and Dennison in there. Stone was a very fine football player for Notre Dame as a tailback. Dennison's an excellent blocker. With that combination, I think they're going to move the ball effectively.
George Allen has never been a run-up-the-score coach. He tends to go into a conservative mode and protect a lead like this as the game goes on. More interested in winning than in spectacular scores.
I would think right now they're going to just come out and drive the ball and give the other teams that they're going to play next week plenty of things to look at, but basically nothing special, because if they can just continue to move the ball on the ground, the clock's going to run out on this other, on the Federals team.
At the 49-yard line of Washington, Stone picked up a first down. There's Allen's coaching record at RFK, including one victory with the Rams over the Redskins in 1969. The other 42 wins were with the Redskins. First down 10. The Federals 49. Bugs in motion. Trumaine Johnson has not used the second half as his personal showcase the way he did the first half.
Well, again that's the same principle. Don't use your best players now and break their legs with a 21-0 lead.
Stone has now carried the ball 3 times in a row. That time Baxley met him and dropped him for a gain of only a yard, so it'll be second down 9. Allen's in an interesting position. In his coaching mode, he would be thinking one thing, and that's obviously the mode he's in now, but he's also president, part owner, and a big part of the early promotion of this league, and from a business standpoint, a 42-0 score wouldn't look too good. Trumaine Johnson, just as I mentioned that he had been quiet.
Just as I mentioned, he might break his legs.
He does neither. Donnie Harris made the stop, but Johnson on the play has a gain of 12 and a first down.
Okay, you can wonder, where is that defensive back? He's back. You see, you can't even see him in a picture. Boom. He hits on a perfect timing cut. Trumaine Johnson has got so much speed, he scares a guy. He's 9 catches for 144 yards. Oh, that's a career for some guys.
Down is at the 37-yard line of Washington. Bugs in motion. Blitz. Landry gets it away. And the Trumaine Johnson show has again begun, and this time it's a gain of about 7, and let's go to Al on the sidelines with Junior IU.
Junior, I don't know why they call you Junior.
My name after my father.
Now, Junior, the defense is controlling this game. This is the way George Allen wants it, yes?
Yes, it's exactly how he wanted it. We had a very fantastic game plan, and we're following it to the T.
Is this fun for you today?
Yes. Every time you're winning, it's fun.
How did I know you were going to say that? Let's go back to the game.
Benny Smith out now, and Tony Super in at defensive tackle for the Federals. Smith has played well in some instances, and Jim Stone is dropped by Schubert as once again, 206-pound Bob Schubert shows his stuff.
You know, he's not very big, but he's got great movement. Schubert has been impressive to me because he's around the ball all the time. Now watch, he'll give the ball to Stone and he'll break it to the outside. Watch, number 73 pulls. He's going to break the outside, but here's Schubert. Gets off the blocker and pulls him down. I tell you what, I like that football player. 206 pounds and all man.
Attendance here has definitely been affected by the weather. It is still raining. They had hoped for more than 30,000, and they may not have that many. Landry throws into the end zone. Flag is down as he overthrows Trumaine Johnson. And while we wait for the penalty call, let me just lay this fact on you. Attendance at Tampa Bay today, where there's never a problem getting people to come to a football game, 42,407. It was not like that when the AFL started in 1961. See that the call is going to be against Washington.
Time,
State doesn't think so. And I think we're going to go the other way.
Maybe they're going to flip. All right.
Offsides against the Federals. So they'll mark that off after the caucus took place here near Capitol.
Offsides, number 55. First down.
That's why Estes was saying it's against them. He didn't want to be caught.
Hey, even if I was over there, I was drawn off, right?
Exactly. That was a good call because if it was anything less than 5 yards, you'd like to go on a second count and draw them offside. That's exactly what the blitz did.
The ball's at the 25-yard line as the blitz try to spread the lead from 21 zip up to 28. And now Landry wants to go talk to George Allen and the rest of the offensive brain trust. And with 9 minutes to go in the fourth quarter, we will be back in RFK Stadium with Chicago Blitz leading the Washington Federals 21-0. And there is George Allen patrolling the sidelines as always. He goes to the face with his hands. That has always been an Allen characteristic. Let's zip the jacket up just a little bit. Now back to the mouth with the hand again. Almost looks like a third base coach most of the time on the sidelines.
He's won 71% of his games, but the proudest of all is he has a winning edge over the Dallas Cowboys.
Lenny Willis in motion to the far side. And Doug Dennison out of Kutztown State, formerly with the Dallas Cowboys, takes the football for about a 4-yard ride before Donnie Harris stopped him.
It's just basic football right now. George Allen knows he's got the ball game won if he can just control the line of scrimmage and use the clock. He's no longer playing the feds. He's now playing the clock. There's 8:36 to go, and every time he runs it, the clock continues to run.
This time he's inside the 15 and down to the 12-yard line.
Okay, you cannot stop this guy. Now watch him. He drives himself deep. He's driving butt Brown deep. Driving Brown deep. He turns. It's a timing cut. He comes back towards the ball. Watch the hand and eye coordination. Great throw. Get out of bounds. Take whatever you can. Terrific play by Landry and Johnson. They will be as good as anybody here is in this league. No question about it.
He was working against the rookie, Jeff Brown, out of Liberty Baptist that time. The Federals lost defensive back Don Burrell, a Canadian veteran who would have played a good deal, to an injury last week. Stone with the football, and he gets it down to about the 10-yard line.
If George Allen gets an opportunity here and he doesn't score, he'll kick a field goal. You know why? I don't think their kicking game and place kicking has been very impressive. Do you, Jim?
No, I don't think the kicking game has been terribly impressive. Corral has only been in camp a week, and while he says his leg is in top shape, I would tend to doubt whether he is the same Frank Corral who used to kick for the Rams.
And they had one blocked.
2-yard gain by Dennison on first down. It's now second down 8. Executive for Stone. In the end zone. Touchdown. And that is Paul Rickert out of Norwich University. Where is Norwich University? Don't call our switchboard. It's in Vermont.
All right.
Good call.
Good call. The guy told us. Now, what happened on that situation? Quarterback will go back. He's looking for Johnson on the outside, but they double covered both outside men, so he throws the ball right in the middle, wide open. Ricker, good hand-eye coordination and catches the ball. And another look at this one, you'll love it. Watch the quarterback. He's looking to throw the ball to Johnson. See him looking outside? All of a sudden, he looks inside. It's one-man coverage, number 50. Ken Bexley cannot cover. Ricker, touchdown.
And that makes it 28-0. So, with 7 minutes, 33 seconds to go in the ball game, the Chicago Blitz, who up to that drive were scoreless in the second half, have added the fourth touchdown, set up by the passes to Trumaine Johnson, and it's now 28-0 Chicago. 61-yard drive in 10 plays. Again, the Blitz kept the ball for more than 5 minutes. All Ricker getting the touchdown on an 11-yard TD pass from Greg Landry, and that's definitely a pleasant moment for Ricker, who, as I told you earlier, replaced Tim Reitman at tight end for the Blitz when Reitman went down with a knee injury. Reitman was really the first big-name collegian to sign a USFL contract. He did it back in August of last year. Squib kick.
Oh, Reggie Smith, face mask.
His face mask's down, and that was bad. A difficult moment.
Yeah, that's a 15-yard penalty, and I'll tell you why that is. That's a dangerous play. You could really hurt a young football player's neck grabbing a face pass. That's why it's a 15-yard penalty and the most severe in football.
Reserve defensive end Troy Thomas is number 79, who grabbed the face mask. There's nothing more dangerous in football
nothing.
Than this.
And a lot of times it's not done intentionally. Watch it. He didn't make, doesn't do it intentionally. He just reaches out. Oh, wait a minute.
So the 15-yard penalty will take the ball all the way out to the 43-yard line. Well, not only did he probably not do it intentionally, you put your hand there on any other player and you're going to hit him around the shoulder pads or the chest somewhere. It's only on Reggie Smith that you get the face mask at that height.
That's right.
Goes in motion to the far side. The pass comes back to James on the near side, and James has a pickup of about three. And let's check in with Al Lerner, who is with Greg Landry.
Greg, the return to football is a pleasant one, no doubt.
Well, Al, so far it's been real fun. I think George has gotten us ready, and we had a lot of rain out in Phoenix, so it looks like we're ready for it.
Trumaine Johnson, having him to throw to, has made you look better, no doubt.
Well, Trumaine would be great in any professional league, and I think he's going to have a great career in this league.
I saw your thumb in some ice water before. What's the matter?
Well, I sprained it a little bit in the first period, but, you know, when you're winning, you never have any injuries. Okay. They all seem to disappear.
Greg Landry, the quarterback. Thank you.
Reggie Smith and Joey Walters go to the far side of the screen. Excuse me, Link.
I was going to say, I think you've seen the last of that Landry. I don't know if they're warming him up, but Cagle's got to come.
Well, there is someone warming up on the far side, and it is indeed Tim Cagle. So Jerry Faust, if you're watching, your old high school QB, Tim Cagle, is apparently coming in. The walk-off is going to be against the Federals. As we look at the three divisions in the United States Football League, there's the Atlantic, the Breakers, the Generals, the Stars, who are playing in Denver today, and the Washington Federals. In the Central Division, the Birmingham Stallions, Chicago Blitz, the Michigan Panthers, who signed Anthony Carter, and the Tampa Bay Bandits. And in the Pacific Division, it's the Arizona Wranglers, the Denver Gold, coached by Red Miller, the Los Angeles Express, and the Oakland Invaders, where John Ralston is the key man in charge. On second down, Junior IU is going to be in there to dump Mike Hohensee. And that will make it third and a lot of territory for the Washington Federals.
You know, talking to the coaches yesterday at the practice session, they were very impressed with IU's quickness off the ball. Remember, in Canada, he used to be a yard back. He thinks he's died and went to heaven in this league.
Reggie Smith, big catch. It's going to be short of a first down, but it's bound to help Hohensee's confidence as he tries to grow into the season here.
Do you know why that play worked, Jim? There was no huddle. They double-covered Smith. He makes a good break. He gets in slow down, and Hohensee hits him with a perfect play. But the reason why that play was good, there was no huddle.
Here's another one on which the Federals are coming to the line quickly. On fourth down, they need seven for the first down, and they've got it. Joey Walters is inside the 40 to the 37-yard line, and Luther Bradley, getting a call for the first time today, made the stop. Luther Bradley out of Notre Dame playing free safety.
All right, there's Hohensee back in the pocket, throws a shot right in the middle of Walters. He's wide open. They double-covered everybody else outside.
16-yard gain on the play. Again, the Federals hurry it up. Good catch by Hardeman. He slips one man and has another first down. Inside the 30 to about the 27.
The Federals are in their two-minute drill, which means they call the play on the line of scrimmage. That's effective because Washington is moving the football now and also trying to beat that clock.
This one is going to come back as you look at Tim Cagle warming up on the sideline. Cagle, in his senior year at Notre Dame, was the starter for part of the time. Jerry Faust took a lot of heat from people who thought that Blair Keel should instead be the starter. Some suspected that perhaps Jerry was partial to Cagle because Cagle had played for him at Moeller High School in Cincinnati. But Cagle, when he came out of Moeller, Lee Corso, was one of the most highly recruited, if not the most heavily recruited quarterbacks in the country.
Let me tell you, there's not a coach in the world or in the history of football that plays a player because of favoritism. You play the best football player to help you win.
The penalty against Washington moved the ball back. It was an ineligible receiver downfield. It is a loss of down and 10-yard penalty. So it's second down 20 as the ball is almost picked off by Eddie Brown. Now it's going to be third down 20 for the Federals. Joe Ehrman was the man who was rushing Hohensee on the play.
Good
ready for this? Denver attendance, 45,102 for the Denver Gold. Now, it's hard to tell how many people are in a stadium like this when it's raining like this because a lot of people have left. Announced attendance here at RFK, 38,010. I think this league is off to a better start today than a lot of people might have suspected would be the case.
Absolutely.
In terms of paid attendance. Hohensee throws complete to little Reggie Smith. And Smith is back to the 35-yard line before Maurice Tyler stops him. So that is going to make it fourth down. And let's call it 8 yards to go for the first down.
Hohensee's moving his club with this quick release. He's coming back. He's sending five men out and just picking the wide open man. He's calling a place on the line of scrimmage. But they're blitzing him.
Gets away. Throws back. Caught. Flag is for defensive pass interference. It'll be a moot point as number 82, Walker Lee. Catch of his United States Football League career.
All right, now watch Hohensee. He sets up. And I've seen him do this twice against me when I was at Indiana and Minnesota. He's rolling out. He's got great vision. He throws, crosses body, perfect shot.
And that's going to be first down for the Federals.
You notice when Hohensee's in the ball game, excitement because he can move, see, and it can't tee off on him. McQuilkin had a problem because he was sitting back in a pocket like a sitting duck.
Well, the Big Ten has become a passing league in the last four or five years. This guy was one of the better ones.
No question. They blitz him, but watch, he got away from the blitz. And he's chasing him down in 74. Ehrman is chasing him. He throws the ball complete. Tyler on pass interference.
A moot point because the catch was made, so the penalty was declined. Now Eddie Brown in the game as the nickel back. Washington throwing on every down, so the Blitz have five defensive backs, and there's Joey Walters inside the five at the four-yard line. And this augurs well for Washington's offense as the season goes along. Luther Bradley made the stop. The Federals may have found who their quarterback should be.
Absolutely. I could have told him before the game started. Guy, we never did stop that kid in Minnesota. Watch. He's got great vision. He drops back. He's only about 5'10", stays in a pocket, very courageous, and zips the ball to Walter, the kid from Canada. Great play. They're going to score and go in with a positive approach.
You told me earlier that his biggest attribute was toughness, and he is certainly showing that in this instance. He would have folded up. Hardiman and James are the setbacks behind Hohensee on first and goal from the five. He's going to throw, and it's picked off. Luther Bradley, number 27, got the football. So Bradley has his first United States Football League interception after a brief NFL career. And Chicago has stopped the first legitimate Washington scoring threat. 28-0 Chicago. We'll be back. We've got 4 minutes and 17 seconds left in the first United States Football League game for the Chicago Blitz and the Washington Federals. After Luther Bradley's interception at the 3-yard line, the Blitz will now try to gouge out a little breathing space. Landry is still in the ball game at quarterback. They did not bring in Cagle, as we might have expected. Dennison and Sohn are the setbacks behind Landry. We haven't seen Spencer in several minutes. That was Dennison with the football, and he was met abruptly. Number 21, Doug Green is there.
What they're trying to do now is they're going to their short yardage offense. In other words, they got three tight ends in the ball game, and they're going to try to just push it out and let the clock run. It's 3:57 to go, and let the clock run it out.
You like the rebroadcast statement?
Can you recite it by heart from having watched football games over the years?
Are you kidding me? I'm just lucky to be here.
Landry, long count on second down, 8. Stone has about 4. This telecast is presented by the authority of the United States Football League. It is intended for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the express written consent of the United States Football League is prohibited.
Did you notice what he was doing that time? He was looking at the end zone. There's a big clock up there. It's a 30-second clock. And he watches it go down, 25, 24, 23. And he snaps the ball with only 2 seconds to go. That's outstanding coaching.
Landry has also played a few football games in his time.
Now watch. Watch him. He'll come up there at 10, 9. Now watch it. He'll snap the ball with 5.
That's at the far end of the stadium away from Landry.
You can see it perfectly.
Uh-oh, here we go. Trumaine Johnson. Oh, oh, good play. Good play. Jeff Brown. He's got reason to feel good about that one.
There goes Trumaine. Now he's just going to try to beat him on a little outside move. Brown plays this well. Looks at, as soon as he looks up into his eyes, puts his hands up. Great deflection.
There are the deep men. 44 is Mike Guess, and 16 is Reggie Smith. Pint-sized dynamite. As Frank Corral standing near the back line of his end zone, and the Federals appear to be coming. They are right up the middle, almost got it. The flag goes down, way downfield. And the kick rolls dead at the 50-yard line. And this is an interesting penalty call, because the flag was thrown in an area where absolutely nothing was happening.
I'm not sure they didn't have 12 guys on the field. That's why they got close to it. I'm not sure.
Well, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. You're dead right.
That's why I thought they had a lot of guys up front with all the guys
back. Illegal procedure against the Federals. There are the two quarterbacks you've seen most of the day. Remember, Kim McQuilkin started the game for the Kim McQuilkin started the game for the Washington Federals, but came out in the second quarter.
We have 12 men on the field. Decline, first down.
That's interesting. George didn't want the ball back?
Well, no, it would have been fourth down. He'd had to punt it again, but...
Still would have been another punting situation.
Kicking situation. He figures a 50-yard line.
We'll
a defensive coach like Coach George Allen, if he could get a shutout in his first ball game, that would be almost utopia. It would be utopia, wouldn't it? Nothing?
Most great football coaches are satisfied for about 90 seconds with victories like this, right? And start thinking about the next one.
That's right.
Owensy's throw is complete. Reggie Smith starts to pad the stats considerably. Maurice Tyler was there to make the stop for the blitz, and once again, the Federals are in blitz territory.
Watch it, 5'4". Remember, he told us he was open. He comes down, breaks it out to the outside, and watch him go right down with the football. Well thrown, beautiful play. He's caught 4 for 59 yards.
And this time, Hohensee gets the ball into the hands of Reggie Smith again. And it is another first down inside the 30. To the 25-yard line. And now the two-minute warning is going to be given to both benches. And there are 2 minutes remaining in a game in which Chicago leads 28-0. Washington still working to try to get on the board. And we'll be back in RFK Stadium. Ball is at the 26-yard line. 2 minutes to go in a game that Chicago leads 28-0. Next week, on Saturday, the Blitz will be playing against Arizona at home. Then 2 weeks from now, on the 20th of March, they'll be at Denver. Or check it. Incomplete down the middle looking for Walters. It's the other way around. They are at Arizona next week. Then they'll have their first home game against Denver in Chicago on the 20th.
Okay, they came after Hohensee that time. I think there's no question in our mind that sign that said George Allen doesn't win here anymore. The coach wants a shutout, so he blitzed the quarterback from the outside. He might get one. But that situation also, Walter was open for a touchdown if he could have got it to him.
The Federals next week will be playing Los Angeles on Monday, and then on the 20th, they play at Boston.
Fumble.
He got back on top of it.
You know, Washington has showed really a fine spirit at the end, and Hollinsey looks like the quarterback. That Walter and Smith look dynamite. James a good player. They'll be back. They got a nice team yet. Notice the center does not like the football. Well,
official says
play.
Tough luck. Third down, four. So now they face a fourth down situation. Top international milers such as Eamon Coghlan, Sidney Marie, Tom Byers, John Walker on the picturesque shores of Ipanema Beach. That should be a beauty. Hohensee in the end zone. Another interception for Luther Bradley.
Okay, that was caused by the blitz. You watch White, the linebacker, and everybody else coming after the quarterback. George Allen wanted that shutout more than anything I know. He shouldn't be discouraged, because let me tell you something. They got a good football team. George Allen signed 268 players and cut 134 in one day. That's a Guinness Book of Records.
For sure. Now, it is often the pattern of professional football coaches that when you have a veteran quarterback like McQuilkin and a rookie like Hohensee, you may go back to McQuilkin after a performance like this. We'll have to see what happens next week. We'll be back in a minute in RFK. We've got a minute and 22 seconds left as George Allen returning to Robert F. Kennedy Stadium for the first time since December 17, 1977, when he went out as Redskins coach. Is headed toward a victory. Tim Cagle now in the ball game, replacing Greg Landry at quarterback for Chicago, and that's Jim Stones, who runs the football for a pickup of six. It'll be second down, four. The rain is falling harder right now than it has fallen all day. The Federals won't quit. They have called timeout to stop the clock. That was a good call also, to say the least. Dennison with the football.
It looks like George has built his football team around Landry on offense with Spencer and Johnson. Look like good football players. And on defense, Stan White and those veterans up front look like a pretty good team. But Luther Bradley from Muncie, Indiana, is a free safety. Looks like a very fine football player. At the end of the year, the team is playing the best defense. And the first ball game and all the way through will be in that championship July the 17th. The best defensive football team in this league.
Is met and stopped short of the first down. So unless he elects to go for it, Allen's team will have to kick the ball away, and the Federals will get one more shot. He's short of it only by a few inches. But that's a remarkable quality I think Allen has, to take guys like Greg Landry and Joe Federspiel and Stan White and Carl Lorch and Joe Ehrman and Junior IU, guys who have been in this game for quite a long time, who have been treated as professionals, who have adopted a professional approach, and to seemingly somehow put a lot of the little boy in it, back in it for them.
That's because it's his nature. That's the way he coaches. You know, you ever watch him? In fact, he gave me a good idea. When I got fired, he called me and said, "Lee, I got a great book for you to read." I said, "What is it?" He said, "Merry Christmas, you're fired." You know, he set the all-time record. He's the only guy that's been fired four times in coaching. Most of us don't last that long.
Baseball managers laugh at a stat like that, Lee.
But he's going to punt the ball because he wants that shutout. All defensive coaches love shutouts.
Finish the line.
Reggie Smith, deep to receive for the Federals. He's had quite a work day. Frank Corral back to kick it for the Blitz. Set a wall up for Smith. Now he's going to go the other way. I'll tell you, he looks just as good here today as he ever was with Atlanta. Our cover coverage of United States Football League will continue next Sunday, 1:30 Eastern Time, New Jersey with Herschel Walker against Philadelphia with Kelvin Bryant. Junior IU. It is ruled an incomplete pass, so it'll be second down 10 as Owensy's arm was in motion as IU got to him.
Junior's third sack.
Junior was there, so was Ehrman.
Junior IU is so quick off the ball, he just gets around the offensive lineman before he has a chance. Boy, he's a slender-looking defensive lineman, isn't he?
238 pounds, 6 feet 3 inches tall.
That's why he went to Canada. Must not have been bulky enough, but I tell you, he's a fine football player for a 10-year veteran.
A good throw down the middle, lofting it over the defenders to get it to Joey Walters, and Walters gets to the 34-yard line before Luther Bradley stopped him for the blitz. So with 23 seconds on the clock, Owensy still chucking away. The Federals are going to get one more chance to get on the scoreboard and mar George Allen's shutout. Smith and Walters both to the near side. Owensy,
pass interference.
Smith is the man who gets the flag, and now let's explain the new pass interference rule. Pass interference can be interpreted in this league as either intentional or unintentional. The intentional pass interference carries the penalty used by the National Football League. You get the ball at the spot of the infraction. The unintentional pass interference call calls for a 15-yard penalty marked off from the line of scrimmage.
Defensive pass interference. First down.
That was the 15-yard mark off.
The reason they have that is so the guy throws the ball 56 yards down and tripped it in the 56-yard penalty.
In the end zone, he's open, and Owensy has a touchdown pass. Walker Lee, a walk-on at North Carolina, a walk-on in the United States Football League, and the first Washington Federal to get on the board this year. He did it with 8 seconds left on the clock. The defensive back fell down.
Well, that's got, listen to the crowd. What a great cheer.
Those who hung around, those of the announced 38,010 who are still here, are waving the banners. The drive, 3 plays, 53 yards, 27 seconds. Comes on to try to add the extra point. Obed Ariri from Nigeria. A part of his tribal name means God only knows. The kick goes through. It's 28-7. A reporter once asked him, Obed, do you mean that you don't know what that part of your tribal name means? He said, no, I mean it means God only knows. It's 28-7.
Okay, here's Holency back to pass. He got a great pass rush on him. IU is coming up the middle, but this is what he does better. He did it against me at Indiana and all the other players. He throws on the run, running for his life with great vision. There's Walker Lee wide open, touchdown. That is what they needed. They can build on that right there in the second half. Now watch Walker Lee. He goes down about 15 yards and breaks across the field. He runs towards the middle in the open, and Livers drops down, and he catches the ball, and George Allen will go crazy on that play. He wanted that shutout bad, but it's now 28-7.
You know, the other receiver who was down there looked like he was open, too.
Well, they can build on that. See what I'm talking about? That coach can talk about the enthusiasm, the way they played in the second half, and you're down 21-0, but what was it at halftime?
21-0. They've got a flat-footed tie.
Now they got
half.
7-7. We showed great poise, and congratulations, and both teams are happy.
Would you start Owensy next week, or would you go back to the
book? Are you kidding me? Absolutely. Owensy, Walters, Smith, throw it, and hold on. Because I tell you what, Owensy's a competitor. One thing also, when they kick the extra point, somebody say, why didn't they go for two to make it 28-8 or something? But they needed to get that kid, Ariri, to kick one. So next week, he could win the game.
Craig James had no room to breathe today, but if they can do this with the passing game next week, he will get a chance to run the football in a little daylight. Obed Ariri, onside kick. I love a team that doesn't quit. And number 24, Virgil Livers, who was beaten on the touchdown pass, recovered the onside kick. So now the clock remains stopped with 8 seconds left. Not a tick on that one. And Tim Cagle will come on for the last play of the game. In case you're wondering, if there is a tie in the United States Football League game, this league has the same rule as the NFL, a 15-minute quarter, sudden death, tiebreaker. Second half, the Federals got 9 first downs, same as Chicago. They've always said Cagle was slow. He even looked slow falling down.
That was a good ball game.
Good ball game for the Chicago Blitz and for George Allen, who has made a triumphant return to RFK Stadium in Washington.